celebrity chef and host of cooking channel Secret Eats, Adam Richman.
Is coming up at
noon.
Okay, so just really simple. We're gonna do garlic oil, herbs, salt, pepper, a little bit of butter, and we're done. So we have two sirloin, and we're basically just gonna season them. We're gonna go about 12 inches above, and just a little bit, because they get equal disbursement. That way you don't sort of over salt.
Okay.
Now the other thing is salting the meat ahead of time is gonna allow like it to retain moisture at the end, develop that lovely crust. And also, people don't realize that in a pepper mill, if you change this, you can get a greater, like more coarse grain of pepper. So I want like bigger grains of pepper. So you can actually sort of dial the size of the grain you want.
I didn't know that.
And you really want to pack them in. I know it's not neat. And so what you want to do is let the seasoning sit in the steak for about 10 to 15 minutes. I did indeed, but it's all going to cook it, like into it, onto it.
So you've got this skillet here, this kind of skillet.
Yeah, really careful.
I will not touch it. But no, this is important. Cook it in one of these.
Absolutely. Okay. Cast iron is stainless steel. It's going to retain the heat, disperse the heat evenly.
Okay.
So here's the thing. Using tongs, and this is the important bit, unless you want to look like the Phantom of the Opera or something, you want to lay the steak in away from you. And that's the sound you want. Now, here's the real trick. Guys at barbecues, like my late pot, may rest in peace, love touching the burgers and pressing the burgers. Put it in the pan and leave it alone. You want to make sure you just have enough room between them, and you want those things to form a nice sear, roughly 2 minutes each side,
okay.
And the steak will kind of tell you when it's ready. It's going to sear.
Right.
So we'll move on to one that we already have a little bit seared off. And what we want to do is, once you've seared both sides, sirloins have this beautiful sort of fat along the back. So what we can do is actually let it render right off into the pan, let that oil go, and then we're going to start. We have a little bit of canola oil, which is kind of a nice neutral oil with a high smoke point, a little bit of olive oil. I usually just mix the two because you get a little bit of flavor. I prefer to, because now we're going to start adding more like aromatics. So what we'll do is we'll lay this down in the pan. Once you've rendered some of that fat, and then we're going to put in some sprigs of thyme. Some nice sprigs of thyme. You can put it on it, in it, around it. I tend to put them on either side. And then some garlic. You don't even have to peel the garlic.
Really?
That's what's kind of cool. You can put it in the paper, in a dish towel, crush the garlic right in.
You're kidding. And then what happens to the...
It's already...
It's already just in the pan.
The herb doesn't even make a difference. The suspense of flavor, all this.
Okay.
We're going to start adding in, as Gordon Ramsay calls, little knobs of butter. Little tiny knobs of butter. And basically what we want to do is get those butter solids also involved in the flavoring of this meat. So what we want to do is you can actually move it around, or quite literally even brush the steak with the garlic cloves themselves.
So how was it, guys?
Oh,
it was
good.
Recipes, you have to go to today.com/food.
Right.
Everything's on the website, as you say. Okay. That's a good start.